Now, sir, my next question to you is that we have discussed the generation gap and their thought process. But now, if we start talking about work culture, then how you adjust yourself with the new work culture, how you cope up yourself with the new generation and new technology, everything is new for you, then how you adjust yourself and what difference you note between your generation work culture and present generation's work culture?
Okay, good question, Rakesh. Actually, I can tell you when I became a chartered accountant in the year 1973, there was no information technology. There were no accounting standards. There were no auditing standards. And since last more than 4 decades, there is a sea change, total change. So, in order to remain with the present world, one thing I have learned that you have to be a student throughout the life. You have to learn. You have to continue learning from young generation. I think today, whenever I face a problem as far as information technology is concerned, who is my teacher? My teacher is a young boy of 25 to 27 years, with whom I ask the questions. Yesterday only there was little difficulty. My granddaughter, she said, "So simple, Papa, what is this problem?" So you never be ashamed of learning from young generation. I remember a day in 1976, I have taken first computer, what you can say, application, and that was payroll. At that time, there was a punch card, verifying machine, right? And prepare a pay sheet. आमच्याकडे अशी म्हण होती सुदर्शन केमिकल मध्ये, 1 ते 10 गरम पगार व्हायचा, 10 ते 20 नरम पैसे संपलेले असायचे थोडेफार, आणि 20 ते 30 बेशरम, याला माग त्याला माग. And the situation was when the payroll was taken on the information technology system. At that time, there was a test run one, test run two, and so on. And during rainy days, those cards I was carrying in a car were bent. And the pay was delayed by about 10 days. Everybody blamed me. That what is this information technology? But today, is it possible to work without information technology? Answer is no. Even a barber, tailor, grocer, small businessman, everybody is having the computerized system. Therefore, you have to be a student throughout your life. Number one. Number two, you have to learn. I always say in professional meetings, chartered accountant is financial doctor. Chartered accountant is financial architect. Chartered accountant is financial engineer. Chartered accountant is financial lawyer. And today, the chartered accountant is business solution provider. You change your role. It is not that we are left the auditing, but you are a person with value adder. You can do something for the organization. And for that purpose, you have to learn throughout. For a professional, I understood one thing I learned by experience, that you must have updated knowledge. That's why I say technical know-how, practical do-how, and marketing know-how. You have to market yourself. You have to earn cash. And for this purpose, you have to spend a lot of time on learning. I always say learning, de-learning, and relearning. Whatever you have learned might have become outdated. You have to relearn, or you have to learn completely the new things. And this is required for a professional. So that sea change is very, very important. Number two, once you get stabilized, I always advise to the young chartered accountants. They say, "Sir, I want to work in equity research. I said, what do you know about equity research? He said, no, sir, I have to learn. I say, the chartered accountant firm or any other commercial organization is not a charitable organization. They're not going to learn you. You have to learn yourself. That means the young generation has to learn throughout. I think I remember when the information technology started, I didn't have a time, but I learned COBOL language at 10 o'clock night. And because time was not there. And today also I'm learning something new daily as far as information technology is concerned, accounting standards are concerned, auditing standards are concerned, sustainability reporting is concerned. You have to learn throughout. So remain student throughout your life. The mind of young generation, they want to encash immediately. Chartered accountant, you are a chartered accountant. Tomorrow you must earn. That may not be possible. You have to keep patience. There is some gestation time. Right? And that gestation time, you have to keep little bit of patience. And that is very important. I want to do too many things at a time is not possible. We were not ashamed to go on bicycle after becoming chartered accountant also. Today you want a car on day one. Today you want smart equipment on day one. That is difficult. That makes your life difficult. Because I said, why we are happy, my generation? Earn now, spend later. If I have a money, I am going to buy. If I don't have money, I am going to live as it is within the available resources.
Correct.
Young generation is not ready to understand that. They say, no, I want this. Then there are many EMIs are there. Then COVID-19 has created problem. And young generation is facing that problem, but you are not to get depression. Life is precious. Money is not. Health is wealth. You have to take care of yourself. And I think that is very important. So what you have to change, that you have to first be with commitment, with dedication. Whatever the work you are doing, do that work with passion. Get it involved. Decide about do's and don'ts. And do the profession meticulously. That is very important.
Correct. Right. Sir, there is another question came up in my mind, that one person come from a small village, he established a business, and because of him, many hotels, many shops, many restaurants, even your staff got so much job opportunities, work. Did you ever feel that? Did you ever experience that they came up to you, say thank you? Or did you ever think about that because of you, hundreds of people got the occupation, business, or?
Until 2005, roughly, the relationship between a teacher and a student was that of Guru and Shishya. Guru and Shishya.
Right.
Very passionate. But after 2005, I could find some change. I became a service renderer, service giver. They become a service receiver. In between, GST has come, Guru Shishya tax, goods and service tax has come in between. And they are not ready to recognize. After 2005, the generation is changed. There is no Guru-Shishya relationship. I find prior to 2005, there was a very good relationship. And that relationship is very important. But today, that is totally changed. Yes, there is a generation that they always feel you are a creator of our life. And even still remember, I was in Muscat. And one Mr. Mubin Khan from Jabalpur, he came to Pune at that time and became a chartered accountant. When I was in Muscat, he has shown me that, sir, daily, the ticket from Jabalpur to Pune, railway ticket, And your photograph, I daily worship. Because of you, I am here. And in Muscat, I have to increase my stay by 2 days only because of the Mubin Khan. So yes, there is a, what you can say,
no.
There is some, they remember, yes, we are because of me. This is good. Actually, what has happened sometime, where once I was in hospital for kidney stone, small operation. But the bill was 60,000 rupees. When I was on the bed, I was just thinking, in case if my driver has the same problem, from where he will bring 60,000 rupees? If my staff in the office is suffering from stone, and if he has to spend 60,000 rupees or 30,000 rupees, from where he will bring? The day, next day, I have gone to the office, and first thing I have done, I have taken health insurance of all my staff members till today. That in case if any of my, because they are my family members, if they suffer any problem, the money should not be a constraint for them, and health is very important. Yes.
Okay. Meant, now we have discussed all your career, your coaching and all, but let's move on to further. Say you decided to compete elections, contest elections of chartered accountancy. What was the reason behind that? What was your motivational thought that you decided that I'll have to go to the Pune branch or I'll have to reach to up to Delhi? Because you are happy in your education, you are interacting with thousands of students daily. But what was the reason that you once again decided to take one lineup of your career? Raise the bar, what we call it.
In 1985, when I was at the age of 36, I was a regional council member. But immediately I thought, I cannot spare this much time from my daily busy schedule and give the justice as a regional council member. So I left the elections of the institute. When in 2009, actually, I was totally stabilized, established. And I had a second generation also with me. And at that particular point of time, from Pune, nobody was getting elected in spite of good number of chartered accountants. Many chartered accountants from Pune were requesting me in almost every election that you are a person who can get elected. But you are not contesting. Sir, at least now, you have completed your age of 60. Your academy is stabilized. Why can't you contest the election? After due thought and consultation with my fellow faculties or teachers, I finally decided to contest the election. And in the first election itself, I was elected on third position from India. Next time, next time, first position. And the next time, first with quota. So every time the votes were increasing, this is only on account of love and affection. What I thought, that until why I am here, only because of my alma mater, Friends of India. So why not to give back to the institute? Why not to give back to the profession? And therefore, I started thinking that yes, I should become a central council member, the member of the highest body of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. I served on many committees, and there also, you will not believe, I was youngest council member to work for 10 to 12 hours a day for the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Still, my fellow colleagues remember me hard working in whatever the work is assigned by the president.
Then how was your experience as a central council member? Do you notice any changes in yourself or public lookout towards you, or how was their work culture also in council?
No, work culture in council, see, always there is a need for improvement in every organization, including the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Now, I was of the firm believer, and I shared in the Central Council elections also, what is happening? The council members and the president and vice president, we do get involved directly in day-to-day working. I was always talking about that the Central Council of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, like a highest management team or board of directors, and therefore we should take policy decisions. And as far as implementation part is concerned, we should leave to the secretariat, we should leave to the office. However, till date, that has not happened. Till date, the Central Council members, president, vice president, they are directly looking into day-to-day administration, we should have been avoided. Okay. But a lot of things I have done. One of the very important, I am the inventor of UDIN, Unique Document Identification Number. I found in 2011, the false financial statements were submitted to the bank. False means forged. It was not signed by chartered accountant. And crores of rupees loan was taken. And when it came to my notice, I made a police complaint. We pursued the matter, but nothing has happened. I say, what is to be done? Prevention is better than cure. How can I prevent the forgeries? And for that purpose, one day, like Eureka, I got it. I got the scheme of the UDIN, Unique Document Identification Number. And I talked with my council colleagues and on the council table. And finally, it was accepted. And today, I have a pride to say that Unique Document Identification Number system is also going to be used by international organizations as well as number of departments of the central government also, whereby the forgery has been prevented. As far as Accounting Standard Board is concerned, there were a number of issues with reference to converged IFRS known as Ind AS. All those issues I have sorted out with International Accounting Standards Board of London. And finally, all the implementation stages, except for banks and insurance companies, is already implemented during my regime as a chairman of the Accounting Standard Board. What I learned during my Central Council member, that there are too many professional matters are there. Too many things are required to be learned. Daily you have to read something. And whenever you talk with government officials, you have to explain in a proper manner, because sometimes they don't know the basics. So whenever you go to the government officials, maybe the Central Board of Direct Taxes, maybe the Ministry of Railways, maybe the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, Ministry of Environment, you have to take the issue at the bottom, discuss with them, connect with the profession, and try to give suggestions. So that's what I say, chartered accountant is a business solution provider. And yes, this has given me a number of opportunities to improve further as far as institutes working is concerned, as well as the linkage of the institute with central government organs.
Okay. Sir, but after you completed, you are CCM for 3 consecutive periods. After that, I thought that you will stop somewhere, and that's the Jawre sir. But later you came up with the PhD degree. What is that exactly? At the age of 70, I'm seeing that the person is having PhD degree.
Rakesh, you asked a very, what you can say, searching question. Why have I done the PhD? Not for the purpose of joining any college or educational institution. Actually, what was happening for years together, especially last 8 to 10 years since I became a council member, I read what you can say established contacts with them, and they were putting one grievance to me, sir, I am a chartered accountant, but the college is not accepting me as a regular teacher, as a faculty. I know that I can teach income tax better. I know I can teach accounting subject better, costing subject better, but they are not realizing and they are not taking me as a faculty. I say, what is your problem and what is your bottleneck? Sir, I am not MCOM. They are asking not only MCOM, they are asking PhD also. So I say, if you have a passion of teaching, you do it. No, sir, how can I spend now further 2 years time for MCOM and further time for the PhD? I say MCOM is not required. There is a memorandum of understanding between the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and about 140 universities in India, whereby your degree will be recognized equivalent to post-graduation. And based on the CA qualification, you can do doctorate. I have done that. So finally, they were only talking. I said, let me prove them that you can do it. So in 2014, I have taken an admission for PhD in Savitribai Phule, Pune University. And my biggest problem was, who should be my guide? Because the guide also should be competent. And that was a very big task before me. So I contacted a number of persons, but I was requiring, some of my students said, sir, I will become your guide, because many of them are doctorates. But it was not proper on my part. So finally, I got a renowned teacher and head of the commerce department of the Savitribai Phule University, Dr. Sanjay Kaptan, with whom I discussed. And then I have taken admission in 2014, and my subject for PhD is standardization of accounting standards. Standardization of accounting standards in agriculture sector in India. Because I found, as far as agriculture is concerned, I am from the farmer's family. I know agriculture. When I was a chairman of the accounting standard board, I have taken brought my entire team of accounting standard board to Mahatma Phule Krishi Vidyapeeth to understand the standard on agriculture known as IAS 41 or Ind AS 41, wherein number of issues were there and we talked about. So finally I said, agriculture is one of the area which is totally neglected, and internationally India has taken a lot of efforts to develop that. And I was also one of the party contributor for that standard. Then I have taken the standardization of accounting standards in agriculture sector in India. And finally, in March 2019, I got that degree. On that day, 100 people were present. So I asked at the end question when the degree was already, it was first time in Savitribai Phule Pune University, those judges immediately declared that S.B. Zavre is a Dr. S.B. Zavre. And within half an hour, they have given me a certificate. At that time, I had a meeting with many chartered accountants and I said, who want to do PhD? 4 hands were raised. Sir, I want to do PhD. But thereafter, I could not locate them. Where are they? And my primary objective of doing the PhD was give a confidence amongst the young generation. I can do it. You can do it. I proved age is not a bar for education. One has to remain student throughout your life. And those who want to really become a teacher, they have to do as per the UGC rules. There is no alternative. And therefore, I pursued PhD just to demonstrate them that, yes, you can.
Sir, it means I have noted that you have been breaking all the walls that are coming across, maybe financial, maybe cultural, maybe linguistic, maybe your age. All these bars you have broken, and later on I see that you reached to London, IASB.
Yes.
You also broken the wall that was behind, so you went through the out of the nation. How you got that chance and what your profile in that IASB?
Actually, primarily, since 2010, the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and the International Accounting Standard Board, that is IFRS Foundation, London, there were a number of issues relating to IFRS pending here. First, I established a good contact with the International Accounting Standard Board, and I sorted out all the issues as far as IFRS or Converge Ind AS is concerned. So good relationship with International Accounting Standard Board members. Number two, when I was a chairman of the Accounting Standard Board, I have developed a practice that every international forum, every international conference, seminar, India must present something technically, even though it is controversial.
Wow.
And I had presented number of articles, I talked on number of subjects in the international meetings, whether it is World Standard Setters Meeting, International Federation of Standard Setters, or whether it is the IFRS Foundation meetings. And thereby, we have developed good contacts and good image of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Mm-hmm. November 2017, the issue came that India has an opportunity to become the vice chair of AOSSG, Asian Oceanian Standard Setter Group. Now I became there was an election regular. So I talked with the people, they were knowing me because I had a technical presentations in number of meetings, and they elected me unanimously. I think that is very, very important, unanimously. And I have taken a charge in Hangzhou in China as far as the vice chair is concerned. Thereafter, one day, all of a sudden, I received a call from IFRS Foundation officials, London, that you have been nominated as a member of Accounting Standard Advisory Forum from 2018 to 2021. Now, what is that forum? That forum is primarily to give advice to the International Accounting Standard Board on any new standard or updation of standard, any amendment in the standard, any change in the standard. And we have a lot of technical discussions in London. Every quarter, there is a meeting. Because of the COVID-19, now we are having virtual meetings since then. And then we deliberate and the new standard come out. So fortunately, only because of proper presentations, giving the knowledge and being a teacher, it was not a difficult job. That's why I said I have changed my platform. Earlier, the platform was of the students. Now the platform is of the professionals. So image of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India has brought me. And very crucial question was there, that I will become the vice chair of November 17. 2 years I will be the vice chair. And 2 years I will be the chair. Normal position of the institute is you should be a council member whenever you are taking any position. So the issue was discussed in the council meeting that even though Zabre is not a council member from February 19 and thereafter he'll become the chair, still my council approved unanimously that even though he is not a council member during vice chair or chair as the case may be, he must represent India. First time I became the chair of Asian Oceanian Standard Setter. And still not many things to work, and we are continuing that.
So now, are you happy? Means what I am saying that you are not stopping yourself. You just want to move on. But if you sit down for a while and if you think about you, that is it the destination place you were dreamed of, or have you reached your destination, or you have some more to go ahead? What is exactly?
See, there is no passion of earning money since long. So now you have to work only for your passion. You have to work for giving the knowledge. Mm-hmm. I will not say that all the dreams are over. Still, I have an opportunity to work with this Asian Oceanian Standard Setter Group, Accounting Standard Advisory Forum. I'm also a nominated member of the Accounting Standard Board. I'm also a member of the Sustainability Accounting Standard Board. I'm also working with some organizations. Recently, I have formed CACOB, the Chartered Accountants Cooperative Bankers. I found there are a number of problems of cooperative bankers are there. A number of our chartered accountants, they are either directors, vice chair or chair. And therefore, I had all the contacts. I was always asking the question when I meet somebody in Kolhapur that you are a director of Urban Cooperative Bank. Do you talk with so-and-so chairman? No, sir. I brought all those my students at one platform, and that is CA Corp, that is Chartered Accountant Cooperative Banker. CA Suresh Prabhu, we have elected him as a chairman. I am a vice chairman of that CA Corp. So you can do something, and this is for the society and this is for the stakeholders.
Okay.
So it is endless job. Go on working. And I told you earlier, the mantra of success is perfect. Correct. I am not perfect as of today. I wish, I pray Almighty that I must be perfect at least unto the end of my life. So I have to continue working to say that you are a perfect chartered accountant.
Sir, now if we talk about the current generation, okay, your generation was a separate that you can work alone, but now the generation need some arrangements, agreement between us, between themselves to grow themselves, right? But I see there is no unity, even in WhatsApp groups also, I see there are some causes that they are, CAs are not united. So what message you want to give all the chartered accountants that if we, they, what I see that if CAs want to grow in the country and make special name, like, then they should be united, right? But I don't see that there is kind of unity among its chartered accountants. What message you want to pass to them?
During my council member, I propagated a lot, gone the days of sole proprietorship. Gone the days of even small partnership firms also. In order to have your role as a business solution provider, to be an effective financial doctor, financial architect, financial engineer, financial lawyer, you have to change your role and you have to merge the chartered accountant firm. Like-minded people should come together.
Correct.
And then you should work in all the fronts with specialization. But the mind of a chartered accountant is of a sole proprietor, my name. That firm should have my name. Where is E.F. Ferguson and Company? Who is E.F. Ferguson earlier? What is E&Y? What is Deloitte? And therefore, I try to persuade them that like-minded people, you should believe somebody. Once you have chosen a leader, listen him. You will grow. But a sole proprietor cannot look after every part of the profession. It is not that you know the GST, you know the income tax returns, you know the accounting standard, you know the transfer pricing, you know the project financing. It is not possible. And time will not permit you to do so.
Correct.
So all the like-minded people should come together and there should be big chartered accountant firms, not only the partnership firms, but now LLPs, limited liability partnership should be there, and they should work on a long-term basis for that purpose. There has to be a short-term sacrifice also. But have that short-term sacrifice for long-term gain. Otherwise, with short-term gain, you are going to lose on long-term basis. So people should come together and they should form the Indian firms wherein 50 partners are there and they are working together. There can be an Indian chartered accountants, big firms. And that is a dream. I do advise the members in that direction.
Okay. Sir, I need another advice on the topic related to female chartered accountants. For example, most of the female chartered accountants become housewives, or if they work, they work part-time. So in that case, main resource for the countries are main chartered accountants only. Even if there are some females that they work along with the male chartered accountant, mostly the girls go to the housewife and they work part-time. So what is your advice for them? That how they can manage or how they can tackle the situation, and they should also be a part of our entire chartered accountants pool.
No, nowadays, Rakesh, there is a change.
Okay.
Many ladies are working, may not be on full-time basis, you are right, because they have also commitments. Heads up to women, chartered accountants. Hmm. Why? Because they are working on all the three shifts.
Hmm.
Number one, our tradition that home should be looked after by women, so they have to handle the entire home along with children growing. Number two, she has to take care of relatives, her relatives or his relatives also. And number three, she has to look after the profession. This becomes difficult, time management.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, what I'm actually, when I go abroad and find out and discuss, almost 50% ladies are there as a CPA or CA, as the case may be. In India, that situation is changing. But right now, 40% of the total students' strength is of the girls. And soon it will change. And girls are going ahead. This is one of the best professions for ladies. And now we can work from home. So what they should develop? They should develop the habit of working from home. And that is possible from the long-term point of view. Right? My some of the relatives are working in US, lady, female lady chartered accountants. And they are working effectively. Ladies are effective and they should find out a way out how they can work.
Mm-hmm.
Once it has happened, one woman chartered accountant telephoned me, "Sir, I have a private work with you." I said, "What do you want to?" "Sir, I want to discuss something important relating to my life." And when she met me, she said, "Sir, you arranged our marriage. And but even though I am a chartered accountant, I am working at home and cleaning the vessels. Is it my job?" And thereafter, I had their family members meeting. And I talked with them and convinced that this is not right. She, being a professional, she must work as a chartered accountant and you have to give a job. Thereafter, the situation changed. You keep the staff at home, but she is a professional and she should work. And this is a good profession for work from home as far as ladies are concerned. And this should be kept in mind by all the chartered accountants. In Pune alone, there are about 1,700 lady chartered accountants are there.
Wow.
Most of them are working effectively.
Wow. Wow. Sir, another advice I need from you is, for example, a guy who studied all the subjects in the CA final and he become a chartered accountant. And later on, he finds himself confused at the moment that in which area I should pursue my career. Should I go to the job? Should I do practice? If I want to do practice, in which area I should do the practice? And it becomes really difficult for the guys at a young age to decide what is their career choice. You become a CA, that is okay. But now how to decide that you need to go to this direction or left or right?
Because chartered accountant, once you become a chartered accountant, that is going to give you minimum level of a professional.
Correct.
That is start career. Does not mean you become a chartered accountant tomorrow, lakhs of rupees will come to you. Money is secondary. First, you have to prove that you are a value adder.
Mm-hmm.
And for this purpose, there are a number of alternatives are available. Fortunately, in India, there is a lot of scope for chartered accountants. Just to give you, in USA, per 10,000 population, there are 15 CPAs, Certified Public Accountants. In UK, the corresponding number is 22 per 10,000 I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Australia, 18. New Zealand, 42. I have taken all these advanced countries, developed countries. In India, per 10,000 population, there are only 3 chartered accountants are there.
Okay.
Therefore, there is a lot of scope for doing the CA and becoming as a CA. No problem. Now, I always advise young chartered accountants that don't start with specialization. You are a chartered accountant. Within chartered accountancy, there is no specialization like a doctor, medical doctor. That means first you must understand in general everything. It may be accounting, It may be direct tax. It may be indirect tax. It may be GST. It may be project financing. It may be secretarial work. Try to understand in general first. So be generalization. Have generalization. Now, whether to go on a job or whether to have be in a practice, practice requires some gestation. Almost 3 years are required. Job gives you immediate some money. So one has to decide what is your mentality. In order to start a profession, you must have good contacts or you should join some firm. At my time, 80% we were in practice and only 20% were joining the organization. Today, almost 95% of young generation is joining for the job and only 5% comes in practice. Even though the father is a practicing chartered accountant, son doesn't join his firm. He said, no, Papa, I want to join the organization wherein I can serve as an executive. So first important thing is don't think of specialization. Specialization you can think of after doing the work for 5-6 years. See, at the around the age of 30 to 35, you can think of specialization. And you have to work accordingly for that purpose. Doesn't matter whether it is a profession or whether it is a job. Whatever you do, you should be a value adder. You should be an asset to the organization. Okay. You have to show something special. Unless and until you save some cost, unless and until you add to the revenue, unless and until you prove that you are a professional, people will not recognize the value. So your job is for first couple of years, develop your own brand. Do something special that people will remember you. And I think that is important.
Sir, another tip I need from your end is once you start practicing as a chartered accountant, you start noticing that every other day you get the new circulars from GST department, income tax department, and there are many more updates, software updates, and so on. Everything is very messy. Messy is the right word for this. So in that case, how chartered accountant, current generation chartered accountant, should manage his personal life, also practice, handling clients and also learning the new things coming up every day. How they can connect all this work together? What do you say?
So young chartered accountants are under tremendous pressure. There should not be a pressure. Otherwise, you cannot do the work effectively. Right. For that purpose, I advise that nowadays, it is not possible for a chartered accountant to handle everything. But client also don't want to go for the GST purpose to one chartered accountant, for internal audit to another chartered accountant, forensic audit to a third chartered accountant. Therefore, they also require polyclinic. That I should get services under one roof. And for this purpose, solution is only one. Please think of having big organization. And for that purpose, you have to join the firm. You have to merge your firms. Get together like-minded people. So that one will specialize in GST, another will specialize in transfer pricing, third will specialize on internal audit, fourth will specialize on statutory audit, one will on concurrent audit. Like this, we have to develop. Unless and until this type of thinking is done, the practice will not be effective. I wish that every chartered accountant should pay GST. What I mean? I mean, chartered accountant has that capability, and he can. But the picture is a little bit otherwise. So chartered accountant has a lot of potentials. Those potentials are required to be encashed. And for that purpose, like-minded people should join and have the big chartered accountants firms.
Okay. Sir, still there is one more question from my end. I mean, this must be the last question, actually. If person joins a job, he goes into service industry, then he get the ambition that one fine day he will become a CFO. Or else YouTuber, as a YouTuber, I open channel, I know that after particular subscribers, I'll get settled. You were also aware about your coaching. But the person who practices, you don't find any ambition before his eyes that I want to become this, I want to achieve that position, then do you think that practice bores just because there is no ambition in the mind except the financial benefit or something?
No, there should be. See, financial benefit is one, but he should also dream that I should do something special.
Okay.
For example, I have found some of the, in Mumbai, some chartered accountant firms are specialized in internal audit.
Okay.
We never imagine what value addition they have done, different type of work they have done, different type of communication they have developed, different type of reporting they have done. So what the practicing chartered accountant should dream, quality consciousness. He can increase the quality. He can use the information technology to the maximum possible extent. And thereby, I think he will get satisfaction. What is important for a professional? Not the post is important that I became the CFO, but I have done something as a chartered accountant. You should get self-satisfied. I always say that what is required? You require a satisfaction. You must have passion. You should be happy. And for that purpose, unless and until that your passion is completed, that quality consciousness is maintained, you will not be happy. So even for a practicing chartered accountant, he can aim for improvement in quality consciousness.
Okay.
And he can add on the products, service products.
Okay.
Service products. I mean, chartered accountant is also a service renderer. Like IT company, he will say that these are my service products. And he should add on the service products.
Okay.
For example, earlier, nobody was looking after the excise duty at that particular time. Chartered accountant was saying, no, that is not my job. Sales tax, that is not my job. But when GST came, we got an opportunity. So you work. But finally, please keep in mind, work-life balance is required.
Mm-hmm.
And that work-life balance is important so that your personal life and your profession should grow side by side together.
Okay, got it. Sir, now one of the question is, like, we become a CA, we do hard work, we work in an organization, we do a job, or we open a practice. We do hard work all the time. But still, there is a pressure in CA's mind because every month is not the same for chartered accountant. They always go into the pressure zone or tension zone. Maybe in a job, they don't get promotions, or maybe in a practice, the departmental dates aren't get adjusted according to their schedule, or maybe their collections are not according to their mark. Maybe cash flow is their main problem in case of practice. But in that case, how they handle the mental pressures? Because
this
pressure
mental,
has see, become the one of the...
Especially COVID-19 has created a lot of pressure.
Correct. COVID also created...
In one of the professional meet, where only chartered accountants were there, I said specifically, 2020-21 year is only the year of survival. You will not get profit also. 2021-22 is the year of start of your career.
Okay.
2022-23 will be the growth year. Mm-hmm. So you have to have patience. So your needs are to be curtailed.
Mm-hmm.
Your needs are to be curtailed. Somehow you have to survive. Health is precious. Life is precious. And survival is necessary. Survival of the fittest. Those who survive better, they will continue. So days are bad. But these days are bad, not only for chartered accountant. These days are bad to many of us. And think of laborers, think of the workers. And therefore, somehow we have to continue. And for that purpose, only I said, my generation have some saving habits. Young generation doesn't have the saving habits. And that is a problem they are creating. Somehow pull on 2020-21 and look ahead for 2021-22 year.
Great. Right. Okay. Then, sir, any advice you want to give new chartered accountants or any students at current age?
Work hard, with patience, with commitment, with dedication, with perfect mantra of success.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Be a value adder. You must add the value.
Okay.
To quote, I will quote one example. When I was working in BI Research Foundation, and we had a vaccine project, and ours was a NPO, not profit organization, and we are manufacturing foot and mouth disease vaccine for cattle, wherein Hest company, international manufacturers, were competing. Prime Minister of India, Morarji Bhai Desai, inaugurated the plant. And on the same day, the price of the vial of 100 ml was 14 rupees per vial, reduced to 12 rupees per vial. My total profitability gone elsewhere. A wire problem. Challenge was given to me that how do you tackle this situation? And for that purpose, I found the packing cost is the highest. I reduced the packing cost by 1 rupee per vial multiplied by 3.2 million vials. So I have saved 32 lakh rupees per year at that time of the organization. I became a value adder. I became a brand. And even they remember today. So that is what is required. So every chartered accountant should find out what is inside in him. What is that passion, what he has. If he is able to get his secret, try to encash it. Work hard, with commitment, with honesty, with transparency, with dedication. Mm-hmm.
Sir, and at the end, I want to listen that poem. That
actually, there are many poems I prepare. लेकिन एक एक पोएम है मेरी 1999 की और आज आपने जो काम किया वो बीते पल की सौगात
वाह
इन 1999 आई रोट दिस पोएम बात सुनाता हूँ मैं गुजरे हो 70 साल की बात सुनाता हूँ मैं गुजरे हुए 70 साल की यादों की है बारात कहानी है दिल की जन्म लिया गुरु के कुल से शिक्षा ली कर्मवीर की भूमि से कड़ी मेहनत से ले ली शिक्षा कड़ी मेहनत से ले ली शिक्षा धन्य हुए वो माता पिता लेखा परीक्षक का व्यवसाय चुना परंतु गुरुत्व ही जीवन मंत्र बना परंतु गुरुत्व ही जीवन मंत्र बना रखा कदम जब पुणे में डर था मन में अंग्रेजी का इरादा था पढ़ लिख कर खुद को ऊंचा बनाने का इच्छा शक्ति और मनोबल के दम पर झुलने लगा मैं सफलता के झूले पर मनी भाई देसाई जैसे गुरु की छत्र छाया श्रीमती जी ने भी सदा साथ निभाया झिड़पी के शिक्षक और विद्यार्थी ने किया प्रेम दान कितना हूं मैं खुश किस्मत और भाग्यवान थामी डोर व्यावसायिक शिक्षा की ठान लिया दिल ने बेहतर ही बेहतर शिक्षा देने की कर्म भूमि बनी तब ये पावन नगरी बना तब मैं सरस्वती के मंदिर का पुजारी विद्यार्थी रहकर ही जीवन पथ पर चलना है विद्यार्थी रहकर ही जीवन पथ पर चलना है सरस्वती का मंदिर का चिराग सदा जगमगाना है रात दिन काम करने के लिए कहां से पाई यह स्फूर्ति मुझसे काम करवाने वाली वह तो कुछ है और ही शक्ति इस ज्ञान सागर को सरोवर को लहरे से आजमा रहा हूं परिपूर्ण परफेक्ट के लिए तो जी रहा हूं परफेक्ट के लिए तो जी रहा हूं बीते पल की सौगात लेकर नियोजन करना है आने वाले कल का अब तक कमाई हुई कीर्ति आबादी रखने का इरादा है पक्का बीते पलों की याद है सच्ची सौगात बीते पलों की याद है सच्ची सौगात आगे चलने के लिए यह तो है यादों की बारात यह तो है यादों की बारात
थैंक
यू राकेश
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर तो दोस्तों ये थे जावरे सर आपको जब भी मोटिवेशनल कुछ एडवाइस लगेगा तो आप जरूर ये वाला वीडियो देख लीजिएगा बहुत बहुत हेल्पफुल रहेगा आपकी जिंदगी बनाने के लिए खासकर आप चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट हो तो आपने ये वीडियो आपने पूरा स्टार्ट से एंड तक देखना चाहिए थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, आप
थैंक यू
ने मुझे मौका दिया,
ऑल द बेस्ट, गॉड ब्लेस यू,
टेक केयर करिए आप,
थैंक यू थैंक यू थैंक यू.